The chapter of the four kingdoms. Once again the apostle speaks, there are four great kingdoms in the world. The first is the kingdom of the land of Babylon and of Persia. The second is the kingdom of the Romans. The third is the kingdom of the Axumites. The fourth is the kingdom of Silas. These four great kingdoms exist in the world, there is none that surpasses them. Yet, I say to you in truth that whoever will give bread and a cup of water to one of my disciples on account of the name of God, on account of this truth that I have manifested, that one is great before God. He surpasses these four great kingdoms, which are so great. He does more than their armies, because they did not listen to God's truth, nor did they help righteousness. Not only this, but whoever will give bread and a cup of water to a catechumen of the truth, on account of the name of God and on account of the truth that is manifest, that one is brought near to the truth. His end will turn to rest forever. Just as the saying that the good Saviour uttered, whoever will give bread and a cup of water to one of these least of the faithful who believe me, on account of the name of a disciple, now, the Saviour is calling these saints least of the faithful. So, behold I have proclaimed of the catechumens that whoever will fellowship with catechumens who are with the knowledge, and helps them, he surpasses these kingdoms that I have counted for you, because all these kingdoms know not the truth of God. For they the lust of the world and care about livelihood. Indeed, due to this, I tell you that these two persons whom I have named, the faithful catechumen and the faithful righteous one, are the ones in whom the Holy Spirit dwells, he sees, indeed, because of this he will give them alms and fellowship with them. He gives it for the Holy Spirit that dwells in them. The Holy Spirit too will give his thanks before his true Father. And the true Father will repay his reward at the last day because of the Holy Spirit that dwells in these saints. How great is this truth that I have unveiled for you! Due to this I have told you, blessed are these who will hear and believe it, and set their heart upon it with a single mind,